Good afternoon, everybody. Today for dinner, we are going to be repurposing leftovers. Because we had a barbecue, what is today, Wednesday? On Sunday, and we kept the leftovers sealed nicely in Tupperware, so it's still good. So I'm actually going to be repurposing it because we have salmon and it's really good. So I'm actually going to be pan frying the salmon first to kind of like sear it. And then we're going to do an artichoke cream sauce because I love these things. These are so yummy. Hi, Sherilyn. Hi, Mom. Hi, Leanne. Hi, cool people. I'm just heating up the pan too high because I want to sear the salmon first. So this salmon was originally baked in like a lemon dill sauce. Hi, Sean. Hi, Sharon. So these are leftovers. And he made so much salmon that I took home a bunch for us. And he actually made a sauce for it, but I grabbed the one that was unsauced. And so I'm gonna just kind of warm them up first. I'm cooking spaghetti noodles in the microwave pasta maker right now, because we're gonna eat this cream sauce with pasta. And I know that it's not keto. Today is a I don't care about it day. So a couple pieces of salmon. I'm just gonna reheat it by searing it first. And I'm gonna set them aside. Hi, Rachel. Hi, Cole. Hi, Ash. So I'm just gonna brown it on each side. And I'm gonna transfer it to a plate. And then I'm gonna make the sauce. The pasta is still cooking. There's 6 minutes left. I just wanna get it. Can you guys see the pan? Kinda. You guys can kinda see it. I'm just gonna, like, I want it to be crispy. And I could use the micro grill for this, but if I'm gonna use a pan, I may as well just minimize the dishes. I'm just searing it on both sides. So I didn't need to put any oil. It is hot, Mom. The girls are in the pool. And I just mowed the lawn. Again. So that it's not out of control. And then I ripped off all of the paria that was on the back fence. I ripped it all out because it made the yard. It makes the yard look like cramped with all that bitumen and leaves all over the thing. Nancy, I'm in Hawaii, in Waipahu. Because the bitter melon leaves was like going all over my gate, like the gate, and it makes the yard look ugly. Man, this smells good. I want to get it super duper crispy on both sides. A little bit more on that one. So it's probably, oh yes, I'm live. I thought you said, where do you live, Nancy? I'm live now, yes. So if I'm ever on and you're wondering if I'm actually live or not, in the top corner of the screen, it'll have the red live little rectangle. It'll say live there. And if I'm not, it won't have it there. And I can tell if your comments are given to me on a live because there's a red dot next to them. Hi, Linda. I'm just searing this baked salmon. I hate to like waste, and these are leftovers from the other day. So I'm searing it, and then I kind of just came up with this because I like the way this tastes with everything. Chicken, fish, all kinds of stuff. And I'm going to add a little bit of Parmesan cheese and a little bit of heavy cream and fresh garlic to make a cream sauce that we can put all of this on pasta noodles. Chanel. I figure, like, you know, this marinated artichoke hearts are like delicious with everything because it has that tangy vinegary flavor. It has vinegar in it. So that tastes good with this. And I was thinking about doing like a lemon butter pasta, but all the recipes I was Googling uses white wine and I don't have white wine. Hi, Carrie, we're good. So this, and I just add cream and garlic to it, it'll make a nice cream sauce. So I kind of just came up with this afternoon because I was like, what am I going to make for dinner? And yesterday was our team meeting, and so I ordered pizza for the people that were coming over. And then we had this barbecue food left over. So I didn't want to have to like make something new because we have so much stuff already in the fridge. So instead, I'm just going to repurpose. So I'm going to dump this whole jar. This is a 14.75 ounce jar. Hi, Sina. You like watching me better than the Food Network? Oh, thank you. Hi, Patricia. Hi, Letitia. This is on high. I'm going to lower it because it's going to go psh. Then I'm going to squeeze garlic. I didn't peel it. I'm just going to put it in the garlic press and squeeze it right in there. You don't have to. I'm too lazy to peel garlic today, so I'm just going to shove it in the garlic press. Wait. You don't have to take off the skin, but it does make it easier when you're pressing. But I'm being super lazy, and I don't want to do it. I should have taken off that first skin from the first garlic. I have it on 6.5 right now, guys. I'm pressing garlic this time because I like the flavor of the garlic, but I don't want to like bite into a piece of garlic. You know what I mean? Okay, I'm going to put this back in. I'm going to do 3 to 4 pieces of garlic. This is all the hairiness of the garlic. Like all of that, you know, the thick stringy parts of the garlic? Yeah, that's what's here. This one has like 2 or 3 little tiny cloves. Oh my god, it smells good already, you guys. Okay. Yum! I love the smell of brown garlic. Easiest garlic press to use ever. I'm telling you guys. And I've tried many. So you just lift it up and the whole thing. You don't even need to put it in a dishwasher because it cleans so well. Okay, let me rinse this off. If you guys like watching, because I know you guys like watching my mom cook her traditional Filipino dishes. Yesterday, me and my mom was watching Bretman Rock. If you guys follow Bretman Rock, I know he's an acquired taste. But he does a video cooking chicken adobo with his mom. And me and my mom were watching it yesterday. And it was such a unique recipe that my mom's going to try it. So that was fun. I hope he does more cooking videos with his mom because that was fun to watch. Hi, Chie. Half a day, Natasha Lynn. I'm doing salmon. This is leftover salmon that I just kind of seared on all sides. And I'm making a creamy artichoke sauce to go with it. And I just finished cooking the spaghetti noodles. So the spaghetti is done. I'm just, right now I'm just browning. The artichokes don't really have to cook. But I do want to heat it up nicely with the garlic. So I took like, I don't know, probably 4 to 6 servings of spaghetti noodles and I broke them in half. Put it in here, filled it all the way to the top line with water, cooked it for 17 minutes uncovered. And I am going to drain this. And before you guys all panic, I will be keeping some of the pasta water because I know a lot of you are like, no, don't dump all of it. Put this down here. So I do save some of the pasta water and that's something I learned from you guys. Because that helps the sauce to stick. That's what I learned from you guys cooking on here. Oh, I'm sorry, you guys can't see. So you just put the cover on, and there's holes in the pasta maker, and then you can just drain it like that. And I'm wearing like really bust-up house clothes because I'm at home. So the pasta's all done, nice and soft. Perfectly done. If you're doing larger quantities of pasta noodles like this, one of my tips is when you put it in here, you want to jog the noodles. So you kind of want to feather it in the water. Because what happens is if you overload this thing and you throw it in there and you cook it, what happens is you get a layer at the bottom that just gets hard like a brick. So you want to kind of jog it. Salmon is what you had for dinner. Oh, where did I see? It's on YouTube. It's on his YouTube. I'm going to sprinkle some Parmesan cheese on this. So because you're using the marinade from the artichokes, you don't really need to salt or pepper it because it has all of that seasoning there already. I don't know, maybe 1/4 cup of cream. I don't want to put too much because then I'm going to be here all night reducing it. God, it smells really good. I am going to add pepper. I guess the girls are done swimming. And you know what? The kids love this sauce. You know when I used these artichokes the other night with chicken because I didn't defrost chicken. And that sauce over rotini pasta, they loved it. In the pan, I have a 14 to 15 ounce jar of marinated artichokes with the liquid in it. 3 to 4 cloves of garlic through the garlic press. And I just put about 1/4 cup of heavy cream in here with a sprinkling of Parmesan cheese. And I have it on 8.5. I'm going to lower it. I just painted my nails last night and it's chipped already. I've been strongly debating if I should get my nails done because I miss having long nails. I used to do them long ago when I could afford it. And having those nails done for me is a luxury. So I don't know if I want to spend that kind of money on fake nails, although I do miss it. It makes you feel pretty, you know. So it's reducing, nice and creamy. I like it super duper creamy. You could probably add cream cheese to this if you wanted to, but I won't. What? About what?
My bird slice of pizza here.
Oh, I'm busy. Hi, Brandy. We're doing salmon. I'm gonna add a little bit more. About 1/4 to 1/2 cup, because I want it super duper creamy. It smells yummy. So, let me plate it. Because it's done. How long was that? A couple minutes? 10 minutes? So let's plate it up. Spaghetti. I wish I had parsley, because then I could be like, you know, make it all pretty and stuff. Hi, Star in California. So this is how I cook spaghetti now after I got introduced to this pasta maker. I don't boil it on the stove no more. So much easier like this. Okay, so oopsie, save that. And then a piece of salmon. And I'm gonna put the sauce on. Turn off the heat. Oh my god, it smells delicious. I love marinated artichokes, so. Oops. I'm not very good at plating. But just enough to sauce the noodles, but without over-saucing it. Oh my god, you guys, this smells really good. And this was fast. So I'm repurposing leftover baked salmon by adding this artichoke cream sauce over pasta noodles. Ta-da! All done. Here's dinner. Ha ha ha. You miss pasta? Another way is to add the noodles. Yeah, you can. I didn't want to do that this time. Oh yes, I did see Jay naked. I wanted to show everything separated first. So there's my dinner. I'm eating this. I'm gonna add cheese. Ta-da. Wow, that was quick. 13 minutes, you guys. That was quick. Yay for leftovers. So you have to get creative with how you're gonna redo your leftovers, because just this after the first time eating it, it's boring. So ta-da, all pow. So I can use this as the screenshot. Cheese. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. This is a fast dinner. Hi, Mario. I made a baked salmon pasta with a creamy marinated artichoke sauce. Ta-da. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'll see ya. Bye.